Third thing is, moms have a head for money. Moms have a head for money because I tell you what, good moms are famous for doing without. It's so nice when dad comes home with a new dress or a new top or, you know, something like that, because mom will not spend the money on that kind of stuff. Because, you know, she's just so engulfed in what she has to do to take care of her kids. And how hard that is to make sure that there's always there for them. You know? And that's just how it is. I can remember my mom. My mom would get a gift card to go to some store for somebody and buy something for herself. And she would come back with something new from the community. And she would even spend the money herself. And we saw that sacrifice. And we saw that head for money that she was thinking about, well, I need something for school more than I need something. I'm okay with it. And the kids are put first. She clips coupons. She looks for deals. And she doesn't spend on extravagances. And dad's while looking at you, she gets her extravagances from you. Okay? That's where mom gets her extravagances from. From you. You make sure she has this. But that's a whole marriage lesson. We've got that coming up in 2 weeks, the 24th. Make sure you're here. Number four, she knows charity. Everywhere you go now, you have the chance for charity. Amen. I went to Firehouse Subs last night. Because Sammy's weird. He won't even know how much you're in pizza. He says, Dad, will you get me a Firehouse Sub? And I said, sure, weirdo. So it's a Saturday night. It's a fast food night. I go in and I order Sub. And he looked at me and he said, would you like to round up your dollar order to go towards the fireman? Now, how do you say no to that? You know, you kind of say, well, here's my wallet, my credit card, take everything. And the reason that I like that is because of my mom. Now, I also take my dad's that way too, but my mom would give away anything. And I tell you, Dad looked at me when he was dying. And he said, I've put a major curse on this. And I said, what's that? And he said, I've left you this much money, and you have to keep your mom alive. And I said, what do you mean? And he said, you'll find out. And my mom never spent a dime on herself. When you hear that, you think, well, what'd she do? She go, wow, but I'm going to tell you. It'd be the grandchild of the family, four houses down, and she would go charge $150. Buying him all kinds of clothes. And oh, but Danny, he's just so cute. They don't have that. And I said, but mom, you don't have much. And if you haven't noticed when you come to our house, I don't have anything. So when you have to go and live there, it's going to be worse and you're going to be a greeter at Walmart. And she said, don't worry, God will take care of it. She said, don't say it to me again. But I'm going to do stuff for you with your kids. I'm going to do it. And you just do what you need to do. God will take care of it. So I shut up. But that's the thing. My mom always took care of it. She took care of it. They took care of everybody. Everybody was more important than them. Somebody needed something, somebody needed money, somebody could pay electric bills, somebody needed anything. They were always there. Mom was there. My mom, that's why my sister and I grew up. That's why my sister and I, we believe that we take care of the world. Not just the people around us. That's our responsibility. So everybody's taking care of the world. We learned that one from my mom. My mom, just like it says in the scripture, they have charity, they know charity. They worry about other people. Number five, she keeps her family safe. She keeps her family safe. You know, that's a big one. You know, care where your kids are going. Care, you know, I know parents now that do not know where their kids are going. I had a weird family situation. I was allowed to go anywhere I wanted. My parents never said, no, you couldn't go. Well, I wanted to. But other than that, they never said, no, you couldn't. I'm going to go see Elton John in Cleveland. Have a good time. Have a good time. Enjoy yourself. Hey, I'm going to do this. Have a good time. Enjoy yourself. Why is this day? What time are you going to be home? What time are you going to be home? Well, it's in Cleveland, so probably 3 o'clock in the morning. Let's put 3 o'clock in the morning. If you were not home at 3 o'clock in the morning, you better have got a phone call. Why? Or you never went anywhere. And Isn't that mean? Isn't that horrible? Now we get these kids to go off the principal. Where do they go off? Because the principal doesn't do anything. Because they're refusing to allow them to gain independence. So the kids lie about where they're going. They don't know where they're at. They know nothing. There's no communication. They go off and get in trouble. Some of them disappear. Some of them get along with things you just can't believe because there's no allowing of the independence. There's no allowing. There's no trust back and forth in those things. And so what happens is it's that terrible environment occurs and kids get injured and go off on bad paths and all kinds of things. But the thing is you look at what God allows us to do in our lives, He's there with us. And that's what parents do. They allow the children to do things, but as they allow them to do them, they watch over what's safe and they make sure they're in contact and they keep their family safe. Number six may surprise a lot of moms, but I think it's very important, and I always watch my mom. And I can guarantee you that parents cannot hear down from heaven, or I would not preach this today. But number six is a mother cares about her appearance. Mother cares what she looks like. Mother strives to be beautiful for her husband and for her children. And I picture one thing, my mom walking around the house with a bag in her big head. My mom died at 72 years old with coal black hair. Okay? Anybody who believes that my mom's hair is still coal black was never there. I remember as I did the hospice things with her, we would still dye her hair. I remember her sitting in the chair and watching that dye run down her face. I said, I'm going gray early. But the thing of it was that she did that. Mom wore this beautiful red lipstick that my sister referred to Friday as prostitute red. But, which means a dicky red! But anyway, she did bright red, and she did this thing for Dad. But she also did this thing for us. And talked about the importance of maintaining our weight. Remember as a kid, you know, had this mom and dad said, you don't want to do that to me. You don't want to give away. Look nice. We need to pick a pant size that we're hit that size enough anymore. We taught us things like that. And the thing is the importance of parents, it's more than you think. And we see kids today, we see a lot of kids that don't care about their parents so much. And we see it in a lot of places, a lot of things that happen. And one of the things is that parents will give us self-respect. And as mothers teach their children about appearance, they're helping to give the children self-respect. Because we do need to respect ourselves. We need to honor our body. We need to honor what God has made us. Everything that we have and everything we do is glorify God. But we also have to honor Him by the best we can do. And as we do these six things, we see these six things in moms, it gives us an image of God. All of these things are about God. You know, think about it. Go through the list again. Number one, God provides. Number two, we know that God works hard. Amen? He never stops. Number three, God has a head for money. He gives us exactly what we need, doesn't He? Number four, God knows charity, what He expects and what He does for people. Father, God knows how to keep His people safe. And all the things that He does. Six, God cares about His parents. So this gives us an image of God that mothers need to be like us. So a relationship between a mother and child, it's a relationship that both mother and child need. Children need a mother. They need a dad. Adults need a mom. They need a dad. I'm going to tell you that Jesus knew this, and we can see it best in John 19:25-27. I want to tell you a little bit about it before I read this. I want you to think of Mary. Jesus didn't do a lot with Mary. Jesus' disciples did a lot of things to take care of Mary. Because Joseph had died. Mary was alone with him. And I want you to remember, as we do this, Jesus had five or six brothers and sisters. And we know about James, and we know that there were others in places in the Bible that mentions their names every once in a while. But they were brothers and sisters, not true. You could say they were stepbrothers and sisters, because they were Joseph's children, not God's. But Jesus had brothers and sisters that should be taken care of, Mary. And then we look at John. We know that John loved Jesus, probably more than any of the other disciples. They called him the loved one, the loving disciple. At one point, John actually wrote that I'm the disciple that Jesus loved the most. Okay? And you know, a little arrogance in that, right? But John put it down there. And so as we know that part of the story, we come to the scripture. Jesus on the cross dying, John 19, 25 to 27, says, Jesus' mother stood beside his cross with her sister and Mary, the wife of Clopas. Mary Magdalene was standing there too. When Jesus saw his mother and his favorite disciple, notice there that John is writing this, and he said, and his favorite disciple with her, he said to his mother, this man is now your son. Then he said to the disciple, she is now your mother. From then on, that disciple took her into his own home. You see, Jesus provides for his mother. He made sure that John was there to take care of his mom. He wanted somebody special. He knew how loving that John was. He knew the things that Mary had showed Jesus growing up. That's why God picked Mary. And she had shown him all of these wonderful traits growing up as he watched her. Even though the Son of God, she was a human, he was the closest to it. And he was sharing that bond of love that was between a mother and a son and a child. And Jesus provides for her by giving Mary John. And then Jesus provides for John. See, John had all the disciples. Probably going to have the toughest time that Jesus is sending in heaven. Probably going to miss him the most. You know, as we studied today in Sunday school, we saw Jesus, Peter, John, and Charles earlier. But then John kind of disappears off the map for a while. And most people wonder, well, why did John disappear? Where did John go? Why didn't he do as much in the ministry until later years? And the reason why is he took care of Mary until she died. He watched over and took care of her until she died. And then he went off on his ministry. And that's why there's the delay in John. He needed that in his own life. I like my mom. You know, we joke a lot about it out here. Rebecca's probably going to get mad and leave the room. But on the Wednesday before my mom died, my mom went to back. And she said, you know, you need a good son. And he's a really good boy. And be a good mom to you. And she said, so I'm born. Just know that's there. I know a lot of them have been calling back to your mom. It's good to have a mom. Good to have somebody that loves you that much and takes care of you. It's hard when it's gone. So I had a person tell me they thought that was weird. So I started talking with a bunch of preachers. And I don't know if it's just preachers or other people, but I'm going to tell you. Do you know how many preachers that I know that their moms have passed away? Amazing. I think it's a God. And I hope there's other people out there that your mom's passed away, that you have a mom. And it's not just so that your mom can you, it's so that you can be a son or a daughter to live and take care of them. Because it's a two-way street. And it shows their love. And other people see it. And they learn from it. What did they learn? They learn about God. They learn about God because it's a love that teaches us God. You know, moms are there. We don't always get it. We see a kid on TV that shoots 14 people in school, but his mom still loves him. You know, that the rest of the world all hates him, but his mom still loves him. And you say, well, how can she love him? I can't imagine. She's a woman. She's had a little bit of feeling that she was created. Yeah. And that helps us to understand God, doesn't it? We can sit here and offend him all day long. We can do the most horrible acts in the whole world. You know, I know that it's hard for you to understand. He loved Hitler. He loved Mussolini. He loved Osama bin Laden. It's all his heart. Every day. He just wanted them to turn it around. He just wanted them to have a good life. And be what he wants them to be. Which is what a mom does. She She loved her child. She just wants him to get it right and to enjoy life and have all the things. And that's what God is. And that's why he's given us Jesus Christ. Because it's the ultimate love, it's the ultimate gift to keep that relationship going. And you have to ask yourself today, do you have that love with Jesus? Do you understand the love between a mother and a child that you can have that love with Jesus? Because that's what he does. He's helping you get with the Heavenly Father to know how much the Heavenly Father loves you. Know how much he cares for you. The example that you've seen in your mom. If you want that love in your life, then you'll have it. We offer you an invitation to come today and tell Jesus, I want that love. I want to be a father. And if you want to come today and pray that while the band sings, we ask you to stand.